I've never been awfully happy about prenatal diagnosis. As you remember, we talked a bit earlier about our early entrees into prenatal diagnosis, and of course moved into the DNA era very much, and with John Old set up in Oxford a kind of DNA center for the government, which has now been taken over by others, of course. But we trained people from all over the world in that technology. And there's been a lot of interest. It's been slow in Asia, of course, but both in the Islamic and in the Buddhist countries. Much to my amazement, of course, it's taken off in a big way in the Middle East, in the Islamic populations. Whether that is partly this kind of teaching that the soul doesn't enter the fetus till about, was it 12 or 14 weeks, and the breathing of the soul. I don't know why it took off, but Buddhism is very interesting. And in Sri Lanka, of course, it's one of the great homes of the southern Indian Theravada Buddhism, which spread across into Thailand as well, quite different to the North Indian kind of Buddhism, which went north in Japan and so on. And Theravada is very rigorous about the value of life. So in Sri Lanka, as well as doing a bit of so-called science there, I've also been building new treatment centers for them and all that, and trying to develop a control program. But we don't talk about prenatal diagnosis, although there's masses of illegal abortions going on all the time. The abortion is formally, not frowned on, it's disallowed. And yet what's happened in Thailand is quite different. Same form of Buddhism. The Buddhist priests have talked to some of the really fine people in Thailand, like Prawase Wasi, who was one of the fathers of thalassemia, and said, look, if you can make a case that this is for the benefit of the mother and that it's in your conscience, we will turn a blind eye on this. And the government have not legalized it, but they've said the same thing. I think it puts the doctors in a slightly difficult position, actually. But so in Thailand, they've set up a major prenatal diagnosis program in Bangkok and up in Chiang Mai in the north. And I'm doing quite a lot of work in India as well at the moment. And of course, there's a number of centers there. So this question of, if it's thalassemia major, it's not difficult, but if it's e-thalassemia, or if it's sickle cell anemia, where you cannot look the parents in the eye and said, there's a very strong chance your child will be very debilitated and live on blood. I have a problem as to where prenatal diagnosis should stand. I don't know, but you should. I mean, I've been sat on by people like Dr Modell in this country, who believes in that if a parent wants a perfect child and it's possible, they should have it. But it does worry me a lot. And with e-thalassemia, although we know some of the modifiers and we're starting to understand the environmental modifiers, I still don't know. And you see those children and adults, because they don't make so much fetal hemoglobin as a lot of people with milder forms of thalassemia, their oxygen affinity is higher, and they can cope with a life at 7 grams of hemoglobin quite well. Yeah. Now, is it right or is it not to start prenatal diagnosis programs for e-thalassemia at our present state of knowledge? The Thais think it is, I think. As purely as very practical people, and I think it's going to be a big problem for Asia, and certainly where in the stronger Buddhist populations, I see no change of thinking in Thailand, in Sri Lanka, for example. So in Sri Lanka, it's an education program in the hope that people will change their reproductive. They do make a lot of reproductive decisions there through the help of the astrologer. So maybe, you know, the genotype will be one thing that the astrologers may take on board. I don't know when we do the population screening.